Hello everyone, welcome you all. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to compare images in Selenium with Java using AShot API. Now, by default, Selenium doesn't have any classes available to capture the screenshots and compare, but we need to again depends on third-party API, so that is AShot API. And by using this, we'll see how we can capture the images for specific elements, as just like a logos, and how we can compare them. And to do this, we need to download some third-party APIs. So AShot is a main API which we have to download, and it is available in the jar file, and JSON and Hamtrust. So these are two other APIs and jars which are available, which are the supported jar for AShot. Okay, so these three jar files we have to download first, and then we can attach them to your project build path, and then we'll get a few number of classes by which we can capture the screenshots. Now let me show you how we can download and where we can download these three jar files. Now here I have given the links, and I will also copy them in the description. You can find them in the description. So let me just show you from where we can download this. So first one is a AShot jar file. So just go to the Google and just type this URL, and I'm just downloading from Maven repository. So when you just, or you can also directly type AShot here, just go to Maven repository website, or if you don't, if you open this URL, it will directly give you, or else we can just type AShot and then search for this under MVN repository, and the first link you have to download. So click on the first link, and now here there are multiple versions of AShot APIs available. And currently 1.5.4 is having some issues. Okay, there are some bugs available, so we have to download from 1.5.3. So I suggest you download 1.5.3. So go for this. And here, if you are using a Maven project, you can just add this dependency in pwn.red XML. Or if you are using normal Java project, you can just download the jar file from here. So click on this link and it will start downloading one jar file. And remember, just always download 1.5.3 version. It's a little older, but the latest version having some issues. Okay, so this is the download. This is a jar we have to download. So I already have downloaded, so just discarding this. And the next one is, once we have downloaded this AShot, then we have to download JSON. So these JSON and Hamcrest, these two are the contains supported classes which are required for AShot API. Now JSON also we can get from the Maven repository. So let's go for Maven repository again. Maven repository, and you can search for JSON here. Just go to that website. This is a official website for MVN, Maven. And from here, you can just download. Just type JSON, press enter. Now here it will show you JSON. So this is the one. Click on this. Now we can just download the latest version for this. So the latest version is 2.8.5. So click on this latest version. Now it will show you the dependency. If you are working on Maven project, you can copy the dependency in the pwn.red XML. Or if you are not, if you are using normal Java project, you can just click on this jar file, and it will download the latest version of JSON jar file. This is also supported jar file. So I'm canceling this because I already have it. And the next one is Hamcrest. Hamcrest all. So this is also supported. Classes are available in this library. We need to also download this. Again, go to Maven repository and just search for the Hamcrest-all. Now when I search this one, so it will give you Hamcrest-all here. So we have to click on this one. And here 1.3 is the latest version. You can just click on 1.3 and you can just download this jar file. Here you can have the link. And if you are working on Maven project, you can just add this dependency in your pwn.red XML. Okay. So these are the three jar files which are required to work on this, right? So these are the prerequisites. Now once we have downloaded these jars, let's go to Eclipse. Now we have to create the new Java project. So just go to the file, new project, and select the Java project, click on the next and finish it. So this will create the new project. So I already have one project, and here I will create a new package, and before that I need to add the dependency jar. So just go to, right click on your project, and then go to properties here. And here just select the class path and click on add external jars. And here, and before that you need to also have the Selenium jars. Okay, so this is the prerequisite. So these are just AShot is the additional API which we need to use on top of Selenium. So before that, you need to add all the Selenium jar files. Okay, make sure that. After that, we need to click on add external jars. And here, first I will add AShot 1.5.3 jars. And after that, I will also add two more jars. And one is JSON and Hamcrest. So these are the supported libraries. Now open this. So now currently I have added three libraries. Now click on apply and then close. And once we set up this project with these three dependencies, now we can create. I'll create a new package and I'll just say AShot API. I'm just giving some package name called AShot API. So now in this, I will just create a new class. So as a first step, I'll show you how we can capture the screenshot of specific element by using AShot API. And later we will see how we can compare that one with our existing one, expected and actual images, how we can compare. We'll see that later. So as a first step, I'll show you how we can capture the image of a specific element. So normally we'll capture the images of logos, right? So I will just create a, before that I'll show you one application. So here, what I want to do is just go to this application. So this is your Orange HRM application. So in this application, I want to capture this logo, Orange HRM open source HR management. So this logo I want to capture from this page. Okay. So now I will just give some name called capture logo image. Okay. So the logo image I want to capture. Let's take a main method, then finish it. Okay. So as a first step, we need to specify the system.set property, location of your driver, then we have to create the driver object, right? So here I'll just say system.set property. This is the key value of the Chrome driver and this is the location where my Chrome driver is present. And after that, we need to create the web driver object. Web driver, driver is equal to new Chrome driver. And then import this web driver and also Chrome driver class. And now we need to open the URL of application. So driver.get and here I will specify the URL of application. So this is my URL of application. Copy this and put it here. All right. So now it will open the URL of application. Now I want to capture the this particular logo, right? So I'll just capture this, inspect this element. Right. So just inspect this element and this is a img tag is available. Let's copy the XPath for this image. Copy the XPath and identify that image. Driver.findElement by.XPath. And this is the XPath of the image and store that into a web element. So here I will name it as logo image element. Logo image. This is just element. Okay. We haven't yet captured the image. So this is a just web element. Image is a just a web element. Now import this web element. Okay, so now I captured the web element image as a web element. Now we need to capture the screenshot of that particular image. So now we need to use a certain methods and classes from AShot API. So here, the first thing is we need to create the new AShot. New AShot is an object. And with this, in this object, we have a method called take screenshot. Okay, so before that, we need to import this AShot from, I think this is a AShot. We have to import this from, there is a package available. You have to use AShot, so this is the one. Okay, so new AShot, S is a uppercase letter. So new AShot dot take screenshot. So this is a method is available. So take a screenshot. And here there are three flavors of this method is available. So I'm just going to take the third flavor. So here we need to pass a driver as a parameter and the second parameter is an element. Whichever we have to capture the screenshot of the element, we have to pass that element. Now this particular command will capture the screenshot of this particular element. And after this taking the screenshot, we have to store this screenshot in a variable. So I will just create one more variable called logo image screenshot. Logo image screenshot. Logo image screenshot. And this particular statement will return an object of screenshot. So this variable must be screenshot type. Okay, now we have to also import the screenshot from ru.andex.qa2s.ashot. Okay, now this variable contains a image screenshot, but still this image screenshot we should store as a file format in some location, right? So to do this, we have to capture the exact file and we have to save the screenshot as a file format. So now logo image screenshot dot, there is a method called get image. Okay, get image, and here before this command will basically extract the image from the screenshot, and we have to store that image as format of the file. So to store as a format of file, we can just say one more class called image io dot write. So this is a method available, image io dot write, and here the first parameter should be logo image screenshot or get image. So this will capture the image, and the second parameter will be the extension, in which extension we have to store that image. Let's say png is the extension. You can also use another extension. Now this particular file, this particular screen should be saved as a file format. So that part we have to create one more file object here, file, and we have to specify the path, location where you want to store this. So I want to store this file in somewhere in the C drive under Selenium practice under logos. So currently I don't have anything. So here I want to store my screenshot. So we have to give the path here. So when you are giving the paths here, we have to give the forward slashes. Okay, so in this folder, I want to save with some name. So let's say orangehrmlogo.png. So this is the name of the file. All right, so this is how we need to capture the screenshot and save that as a file format. Now this file will accept create method file we saying, and we have to create the new keyword. Okay, new keyword, because this is a file object. Now import that from java.io. All right, so now this particular command will expect some exception, just add it. Now this particular command will capture the exact image from the screenshot and store that into this particular location. Now import this file also from java.io. Okay, so this is a piece of code which we have to write. So here logo image screenshot, this will capture the screenshot from that particular web element which we have already identified, and image io.write is another method which will capture the image from this screenshot and store that image in the form of file in this particular location, and the format of the file is png. Okay, so now if you want to verify whether the file is captured and stored in that location or not, if you want to verify, we can just write one method here. So here what I can do is I can just store this path in a variable. So let's say I'll create one file variable, file f is equal to new file. What is the location of the file? This is the location of the file, and copy here. Okay, so this is the exact location of the file. So file f is equal to new file of this one. So this f is representing the exact file. Now here I will verify if f dot exist. So if the file is already exist, this condition becomes true now. Now here I will write image file capture, and else if the file is not exist, and then image file not exist. Okay, so this is how we can capture the specific web element image from that image, screenshot, we have to capture the image and store that into a file format, and we can also verify whether the file is captured or not. All right, so currently in the same directory, in the folder, I don't have any files. Now I'm going to execute this code. Let's run as Java application. Now I have run this, I have run this code. Now it is started Chrome browser. Okay, now it is launching the page, and after the launching the page, it should take. So now image file is captured. Now let's go to this location. Now image file is captured. So this is the image file we have just captured. Okay. So this is how we can use a AShot API to capture the screenshot of specific element, especially for the logos. It is very, very useful. Okay. Now I'll show you the next step. So once we have this image, so suppose I already have some image like this. I want to compare this image is exactly same as a image which is displayed on the web page. Okay. How we can compare these two images? Now I'll show you the next step. So let's create another class, another test case. Let me create, and here in this class I will compare the screenshots, compare images, and I name it as a compare images. Let's take a main method, then finish it. Okay, so here this is a completely new code I'm going to write, but here what we have to do is this is our expected image. Okay, this image, and this is the actual image which is there in the application. So we have to compare these two images, right? But before that, what I have to do is first I need to capture this image, right? In the same way in how we have captured this image in previous session or previous example, similar way we have to capture this image, and this should be our this should be actual image, and this is our expected image. Okay, now we have to compare these both are exactly equal to or not equal or not. So that's how we can do. So here also we have to capture this image, but we already have captured earlier. So we will compare the newly captured image with the existing image. Okay, so what I can do is I can just create one more class. I already created. Now here I write the code for this. So first thing, we need to again set the system.set property and the key value and location of your driver. After that, we need to create the web driver object. Web driver, driver is equal to new Chrome driver. I'm using Chrome driver. Okay, and then import this web driver and also import this Chrome driver. Right, so now I'll open the URL of application. So let's say driver.get, and this is your URL of application. This is your URL of application. Now after opening this URL, so what we have to do is, what is our expected image? Where is our expected image is located? Here, right? So this is our expected, and let's give the path here. So I'll create one variable here, and I will store that image inside that particular variable. So let's say expected image, expected image is equal to, how we can get that image? So we have to read this image. Okay, we have to read the image from this. So to do this, we have another class called image io dot, in previous example we have used image io dot write to write the file. Now this time we have to read their file. So image io dot read, and we have to read that image in the file format, right? So new file, and here we have to say location, where is our file is located. Now this is the location of my file, and specify this, and here we have to use a forward slashes, and you have to also give the name of the file. So this is your name of the file, copy and paste it over here. Okay, so image io.read, new file, import this file from java.io, new file, and this is the file we already captured earlier. Okay, so this is our expected image, should be there in your page. Now I'll store this complete image in a variable. Now this variable must be buffered image type. So this entire image io.read command will return you the buffered image. So this is the type of the file. So we have to import again this one, buffered image from buffered, buffered image. So the buffered image should be imported. Again, put this cursor, it will show you different packages. Okay, so here the buffered image should be imported from proper package. I think there is a spelling mistake, and it should be buffered image, buffered image. Okay, so we have to import this from Yeah, so this is a one. java.aw.image.bufferedimage. So this is the package. And then image IO will throw some exception, import this exception. Okay, so now this is our expected image. This is our expected image to be there in the application. So now we need to capture actual image from the application, then we can compare this. All right, so how we can capture the image from the application? That is again same process. In the previous example, I have seen a similar way. We have to identify the element again. So capture this image, inspect this image, and capture XPath for this image. Now driver dot find element by dot XPath, and this is your XPath of the image. So store that into a web element, and this should be logo image element. Logo image element. This is just a web element. So from this web element, we need to again extract the screenshot and also image. So how we can extract this? So we have a method called new a shot. This is again same, just like a previous one. So a shot is a method dot take screenshot. A shot. So a shot we have to again import. And a shot dot take screenshot, take screenshot, and here driver we have to pass, and the second part is a element. So I'm just passing this element. All right, so this particular statement, new a shot dot take screenshot driver comma logo image element, so this statement will capture the screenshot of the element whichever we pass here, and we have to store that into some variable. I'll just say logo image screenshot. Logo image screenshot. Now this is just capture the screenshot. Okay, so here element, there are three things are here. One is element, the other one is a screenshot, and the third one is an image. So from this element we are extracted the screenshot, and from this screenshot we have to extract the exact image. So this variable should be screenshot type. This should be screenshot type. Okay, now again import the screenshot. Okay, so here this is a web element. From this web element we have captured the screenshot, and from this we have to again capture the screen. So we have again captured the image. So the next statement, so this is a just a logo image screenshot. From this web element we captured the logo image screenshot, and from this we need to capture the again image. Okay, so how to capture? Use this value logo image screenshot dot get image. Get image. So this method will give you the exact image. So as I said before, there are three layers. One is identify the element, based on that element capture the screenshot, and from the screenshot now capturing the image. Okay, this is actual image which we need to compare with. So I will store this image into actual. So this is your actual image. Actual image is equal to, and what kind of type it should be? It should be again same type, buffered image. Alright, so now I have expected image, and the expected image there in this location, and now I'm capture the actual image from the application. So now we need to compare these two. So expected image and capture image. So these two I have to compare. So to compare the images, we have a special class available, image defer. Image defer. For this class, we have to create one object, because we have to access certain method from this class. So image defer, image def is equal to new image defer. So this is a present class. So import this class from again QA tools a short dot comparison. And after this, we should also create one more object for image def. There is one more class called image def, because this object will store the exact result. Okay, so image def, and def is my object, is equal to. Right, so from this image diff, there is a method called make diff. Okay, make diff is a method. So here we have to specify the actual expected image and actual image. So this is your expected image, so pass it here, and this is your actual image, so pass it here. So now what this will do is it will compare these two images, and the difference between these two images will be the result of the difference will be stored in this variable. Diff variable. Now import this image diff. Okay, now this is exact actual variable. Okay, now we have to write one condition. If this diff variable has diff, okay, this is a method again. So diff dot has diff is equal to true. What does it meaning is, the meaning of this one is diff dot has diff. That means if there is any difference, okay, if that is difference, true means condition is positive. So if there is any difference, then what should I print here? System dot out dot println. I can print here is images are not same. Images are not same because there is a difference. So diff dot has diff is equal to true. If there is any different, that means images are not same. So if there is no difference, so diff has diff is equal to false, and then that means there is no difference. Exactly, both are equal. So system dot out dot println. I can just say print images are same. Okay, so this is how we need to validate. And after comparison, we can just close the browser. I'll say driver dot quit. Okay, so this is a how we need to capture actual logo from application or web page. Then we have to compare both of them. So expected image and actual image. Both we have to compare by using image diff class, and there is a method called has diff. So this will compare. This will compare two images. Two images. Alright, so now let us run this code. So currently I already have this image. Okay, so now I've mentioned this path here. Okay, this is our expected image, and again it will take the image screenshot from the application at the runtime dynamically, and then it will compare with the existing image. If both are exactly the same, it will say images are same, or else it will say images are not same. Okay, now let's see the positive condition. So this image is already there in application. So now I'm running my code, and now we will see that Java application, run as Java application. Now let's see, it will open up the page. Okay, now it is launching the Chrome browser, and after capturing image, compare it and closes. Now we can see images are exactly the same. Okay, this is your positive scenario. You both are images are same. So now what I will do is, I will just make small difference on this particular image. Okay, so I will just modify this image. Let's open with the paint, and now I'll add something here. Okay, some dot, I'll something I have added. So this is image is different. Now save this. Okay, now images comparison should fail, right? So let's run this one more time. Run as Java application. Okay, now it is launching the page. Okay, now you can see images are not same. So there is a change in the images. Alright, so this is how we can just compare the images by using this particular package. Okay guys, so AShot is very important package, and this is again third party API, and by which we can access certain number of methods and we can compare the images. Alright, so that's all for this video guys. So thanks for watching this. Please subscribe my channel to get more updates on this. Thank you all.